9-year-old Omaree Varela's death has inspired many more people to report their suspicions of child abuse.
As KOAT Action 7 News reporter Lana Grimstad explains, the effects of this tragic abuse are having an impact far beyond the Albuquerque city limits.
Omaree Varela has become a prime example of child abuse discovered too late. After the 9-year-old died last December, his autopsy report revealed a history of disturbing abuse. His own mother is accused of beating him to death. Unfortunately, officials say Omaree's case is far from the only one.
A lot of kids being hurt.
And more of them.
They don't want to make another mistake.
At the Solace Crisis Center in Santa Fe, forensic interviewers talk with kids to find out if they've been abused. Recently, the center's seen a huge spike in cases as police and the public are reporting more often.
They don't want to be responsible for another child dying, because an investigation was dropped.
It was just after Omaree's death, and February was one of the busiest months in the center's entire history, with more calls of child abuse than nearly ever before.
We do this work because when we come together, children turn their lives around one case after another.
Statewide, experts say both police and everyday people are now on even higher alert.
I think everybody suffers.
And aren't just minding their own business now that they've seen the consequences of staying quiet.
To not dismiss any potential scenarios where they can be the ones stopping something bad happening to a child.
In Santa Fe, Alana Grimstad, KOAT Action 7 News.
The Solace Center is now training more interviewers to help meet the increased demand. This weekend, community members and leaders in Santa Fe will mark Child Abuse Prevention Month with a march from the Capitol to the Plaza.